Well, Intel wants to bring technology to everyone on the planet, and you need to do that in an affordable way, in a secure way, and you need it to be in a way that enriches and improves their lives. Otherwise, they won't pay for technology, and do it in a way that can reach lower-income people as well, even if they share technology. In my specific area, I focus on digital divide, the lower income, and spend a lot of time in the education world, primarily through government leaders, ministers of telecom, ministers of education, ministers of finance, to help them implement these programs in their countries. What we do is we work with the telecoms, we work with the regulators, the regulatory authorities, and we've worked on business models there where broadband has become more and more wireless these days rather than wired. It's 3G, it's 4G. That's what reaches the people. And in that, we've worked with the telecoms on lower cost computers, tablets. So they'll take their business models and adjust them so you can have lower tiers of pricing in the prepaid model, just like has happened on the voice phone. That way you reach far, far more people. Now, if you're reaching far, far more people, people can take their computers home from schools, they can use them in the schools, the university students can afford laptops and capabilities in there. And so it's really about affordability and reach. And in Intel, we just build the comms communications capabilities into every platform. Well, obviously, over time, the price of computers has been coming down. You can get a fantastic computer capability today for maybe $300 or $400. You can get entry-level computers for maybe $200. But then there's $100 tablets around, and there's lower cost than that smartphones. And there's a spectrum of capabilities. Obviously, the higher priced ones do a bit more, but you can do some great basic computing capabilities, an entry-level computer, a tablet, and a lower-cost smartphone. Now, with that, we found over the years that the cost of the broadband can actually be much higher than the cost of the device. And so we've worked with the telecom people on that prepaid model to drive that down. For example, in Africa, 3 years ago, the average price of broadband was $30 a month. Well, maybe 2% of Africans could afford that. Today, you can buy it in $1 increments when you have money. So if you're not banked, or you want fractions of a dollar increment, and you're a university student and uses the LAN in the day, and wants their 3G dongle just for a small amount of work in the evening, you can do that and pay $1 or $2 a month and get everything you need there. And so that makes it much, much more affordable, rather than 2 or 3% affording it. Maybe 30 or 40% can afford it. And that brings the technology to much, much more people. Well, reach for Intel. You know, Intel is not in every country in the world. We have 100,000 employees, and so we're a large company. But what we do is we work with partners, local partners, to integrate and implement. Around the world, we may have 200,000 or more channel partners that exist in every country on the planet. And those are the people that can take that technology to the end customer. So if you look in Nigeria, there'll be many small Nigerian companies that will take the platforms there. You look in Kenya, you look in the Middle East, each of them will have their own local companies that tend to have grown into local solution providers, local channel, local distribution, along with a local telecom. And the reach is by partnering with them, because it's their direct customers and it's our indirect customers, because we're the Intel Inside ingredient here. Private-public partnership is absolutely critical in this, because if you look at, say, trying to reach the schools, every teacher with a laptop to drive their education programs, or if you look to try and reach businesses that may be, you know, someone's home farm or someone's small business, and there's a few people in this, you've absolutely got to reach those, both with solutions and an affordability that makes sense to them and gives them value for the spend they have, because it can be a big piece of their disposable income. So it's critical that we work on that. Now, where the government comes in is the government will look at, hey, I want to modernize education. Well, they're going to set policies on electronic books. They will set policies on I want computers in schools. But the private industry will do more of the implementation. How do you make that work? How do you make a network? How do you train the teachers? We've trained 12 million teachers worldwide with Intel Teach. How do you work with the content companies? And so the private industry is more the how-to, And the government is more a, here's the goals I'm setting and what I'm trying to do for my people and my country.